part in that. So one thing that I wanted to talk about today was finances. Like if you're in a relationship, whether you're married or engaged, or maybe you're just dating, or you know, whatever, it doesn't matter. But if you're living with somebody and then you have to work with them with finances, it's not a surprise that there's lots of marriages. Stephen Rip, good morning. It's not a surprise that there's lots of marriages that fall apart because of finances. And the reason, let me break this down here for one real quick second, and I'll use my wife and I. So when I grew up, I wasn't specifically taught anything about finances. My parents were both factory workers, super, super hard workers, great work ethic, but I wasn't really taught anything specific on finances. And they'll agree with you. I'm not de-edifying them. I'm not putting them down. They would agree with you. The reason they didn't teach me anything is because they weren't really taught anything, right? I mean, that's pretty simple. Like if I wasn't taught something, how can I teach something I wasn't taught? So they were, you know, I was taught just to, you know, pay for cash with as much stuff as possible. If you got to take a loan, you know, I guess you got to take out a loan. But it wasn't like I wasn't sat down and said, hey, every time you get paid, put 10% in savings. Hey, every time you get paid, put this much here. I was never taught that. Now take a look at my wife, how she grew up. And I just talked to her about this 2 weeks ago. And she said, you know, every time she got paid, her parents were played a big part. All right, so you made 10 bucks here, babysitting. All right, this is how much you put in savings. This is how much you have, you know, to spend. Like, she was actually taught something about finances. Okay, I was not taught anything about finances. All right, so those are two completely different worlds, very common here in the United States, right? So what happens is because society pushes down on us to say, look as good as you can, smell as good as you can, drive the nicest car, live in the nicest house, you know, do the coolest things, travel, put it on a credit card. Society just says, do all this stuff. But when it comes to the money thing, don't talk about it. Right? Because if how I was taught about finances, I wasn't really taught anything. So I'm really ignorant when it comes to finances. I'll admit that when I got married, when I grew up, when I was in high school and college and getting out of college, I really didn't know. Same for me. Absolutely. Absolutely. So I wasn't really taught anything. So I was totally, I was really ignorant. I'm not ignorant anymore. I'm more educated. I'm more informed when it comes to personal finances. So I wasn't really taught anything, but my wife was, right? So how do we communicate? How do my wife and I communicate? You know what we did for years? We really didn't communicate at all. But as we went through this journey of getting this new information, we started to communicate. And as we started to communicate, our finances got better. And we got on the same page. And this one analogy that I heard on an audio is, if you're in a boat, like I'm in a boat with my wife, and she's got an oar, and I got an oar, and I'm gonna go ahead and row how I think I'm gonna row with my finances. She's gonna row how she thinks she's gonna go with her finances. How successful, think about this. If we need to go from here to there, 100 yards down, you know, in the water, what are the chances with our teaching of finances? What are the chances we're going to get over there? The chances are like zero. We're going to just go in circles because she's taught one thing, I'm taught one thing, and I'm just going to go the opposite way. She's going to go the opposite way. And it's total chaos, right? Now, what's great about this and the goal here, it's not to inspire you to know that your life can change if your finances aren't where they can be. But I'm a specific example of our finances weren't great. Our communication wasn't that great. You know, our teaching, how we were taught, was not similar, which is not similar for any couple. Everyone grew up in a different financial household, right? So how do you get that in order? How do you change it? What are you reading right now? I'm reading Napoleon Hill's Think and Grow Rich. I'm also reading Brendan Burchard's Your Golden Ticket. What is it? Life's Golden Ticket, on chapter 5. Great book so far. Brendan Burchard's Life's Golden Ticket. A buddy of mine had promoted that. I'm also reading The 1 Minute Millionaire. Awesome book too. I'm in like two or three books at a time. Totally unrelatable. Anyways, so back to like thinking about finances is you've all heard that here in the U.S., I think the divorce rate's like 50 per, between 40 and 50%, something crazy. And they say, well, finances are a major catalyst for that. Well, it totally makes sense. If you look at like my situation, I was taught one thing, my wife was taught one thing, and then now we're in the same house. We got the same checkbook. I got my habits. She's got her habits. She's got way better habits than I did. How do you make that work, right? So we did two things. We did two things right when we started wanting to get into getting us where we wanted to be for our family. Because she was working really hard. I was working really hard. And we wanted to get her home because we had young kids. And we just couldn't do it with our student loans and our debt. We just couldn't do that. But we wanted to get her home, right? So we had to find a way. So we had to change some stuff in our life. So what we did is we sat down and this is something we do on a weekly basis. Is it's normally every Sunday after church. We sit down and we go over our finances. Even if there's no bills to pay in the next 7 days, we sit down, we go over our finances, figure out, you know, what we have in our accounts, what's going on this next week, what's going to cost money, where we're going to spend money, that kind of thing. And we communicate. So the first big key that that we start doing is we start communicating on a weekly basis about our finances. So she's not going to assume what I'm doing. I'm not going to assume what she's doing. We're leaving all assumption. We're throwing assumption out the door, and we're only going to use communication, right? And that's been a huge key for us and for our financial success. Now, when your finances are good, your health is good. When your health is good, your communication's good. When your home is good, your atmosphere and your environment at home is good. It's like when you get your finances in order, so many other things get in order. It's amazing. It's amazing. And if your finances aren't where they want to be or where you want them to be, it can change. That can change. It's just going to take new information and new habits and new disciplines every single day, right? So the second thing that we did, because I was a little bit more of a spender, she was more of a saver. So if I went and got, I don't know, like lunch or something like that, my wife would say, well, where'd you go? And then I would say, well, I just got something quick, right? So when she's saying that, she's saying, well, I didn't do that, but you did. So then she's feeling a little, I don't know what word you want to say. I was spending and she wasn't. So it wasn't like even. Does that make sense? Hopefully this makes sense. So what we did is we just allowed ourselves, I think it was like right when we started, it was like $5 a week, maybe $10 a week. We gave each other like $5 a week. And what would happen is that was our spending money for the week. $5. So it's Monday, you know, Monday during the day. What we would like, if I blew that $5, I can't spend any more money throughout the week. Now my wife, she let that last 3 weeks. I don't know how she did it, but she did. So what would happen is she would get her money, I would get my money, no questions would be asked, and there's like no argument. Because we agreed upon a certain dollar amount, and she never asked me what I spent with that money. And I never asked her what she spent on that money. She probably never even spent it. Who knows? Maybe it's probably saved somewhere. So the first thing that... So back to the two things that we did to get our finances in order. Hopefully this helps. I know this is a little bit of a longer periscope, but it's an important topic. This is so important. So if you know someone that is hurting financially as a couple or even individually, you can use this because you don't have to communicate with a spouse. Communicate with someone that you know, like, and trust, that can help you with your finances, because sometimes you just need that coach from the outside looking in, because my coach sees more from the outside than I see from my window frame. So if you know someone that's